Hey everybody, what is up? It's Cornish Ratbeard here, and boy am I stoked to be back recording content for you all. I know that I've been away for a long time, guys, but now I'm back and I'm back with a bang. So we've got the new patch out, and I cannot wait to get a new playthrough going for you guys, so stay tuned for that. This is going to be an awesome little video slash guide which is brought to you from mine and J4miePlays tutorial series. If you're looking for any more help, then please do check out our tips, tricks and tutorials playlist, which I've linked in the description. So we are going to be taking a look at the Krenim's brand new tradition tree and the reward that we will receive for completing that unique tree. If you have already seen the new patch notes, you would have seen that certain factions have a unique tree within the traditions tab, and in this instance, the Krenim's unique tree is called the Masters of Time. So you will need to unlock all 5 traditions in the Master of Time traditions tree to get a pretty unique and cool reward at the end of it. And yes, you have probably already guessed what that reward is, and you would be absolutely right in saying it's the famous Time Ship, also known as the Weapon Ship. This weapon ship was a warship of the Krenim Imperium, and it was capable of erasing whole civilizations in the blink of an eye from history. It was designed and constructed by a guy called Anorax. I think that's how we pronounce it. I can't remember. Anyway, Anorax is a military temporal scientist, and the ship itself was activated around 2170, so it's quite early, and it was used against the Reinar, which was the primary enemy of the Krenim. While it did initially work, some kind of a butterfly effect kicked in and caused a huge plague on the Krenim homeworld, killing over 50 million people, which is just nuts. Basically, Anorax didn't realize that the Reinar was carrying some kind of a gene which kept them from this disease. Anyway, that wasn't there anymore, so it basically killed a lot of people. So he did attempt to rectify his error, but I think that just made it worse. Bottom line is, this time ship will absolutely do the job of eliminating your enemy, but honestly guys, at what cost? If you are interested in finding out more about its origins, then I recommend watching Voyager Season 4. It's a two-parter all about this epic ship that we can now use and abuse in Star Trek New Horizons. So back to the Krenim's traditions. I'm going to show you what it looks like from the get-go. So clicking on the traditions tab, we see our trees are blank, obviously, but it's a welcome sight to see so many trees that we are going to be able to access. In the past, we have seen our traditions tab laid out a little differently, but as you can see here, it's now laid out in a much more cleaner and easier way to navigate with our ascension perks over here, located at the top left of our screen. I love that. So let's have a look at what we see once we have a tradition to unlock for the first time. Okay, so as you can see, it lets us pick our first tradition by selecting one of these boxes. Once we do that, we get to see what the trees are. Now, they are all going to be very important in your game, and selecting which tree you want will ultimately come down to your playstyle during said campaign. So other than me just whizzing over these, I will let you explore the more default ones. Now, the tree that we are obviously interested in is the faction unique one, the Time Masters. So I'm going to go ahead and put our first point into that. As you can see, we now have 5 levels of this tree to complete. With this faction, each level of the tree is a component, which you will need to complete in order to get your juicy, juicy time ship. Also, as a little disclaimer here, guys, I've used cheat codes to get where I am, and I also recommend you do not start with this tradition first. So, again, to keep the video shorter, I'll mouse over these traditions, but ultimately, you just have to unlock them all. But as you do unlock each tradition, you will unlock some technology, which you will have to research in order to get the ship. Now, I suggest doing this as soon as you can because it can take a long time to research. So pop on over to your research tab and you will see your traditions research at the bottom of the engineering research pool. Once all of this is done, head over to your main Krenim starbase. Oh yeah, remember to start upgrading it as soon as possible, as you will need to have a level 4 starbase in order to do this. Once you have got that, head over to your starbase facilities and build the temporal shipyard. I've also built the large scale shipyard, but can't confirm if you actually need it. I just thought, why not, eh? So with that completed, you now only need the resources to be able to build your timeship. So, I've built the timeship, guys, but let me tell you, it was no easy task. It takes a lot of resources and like over 5,000 days to build the thing. But don't let that put you off, because it's really, really cool. So one thing I need to mention is that when you complete all your traditions, you do get Anorax as an admiral. I just don't have him anymore because, well, he simply died of old age. I kind of left the game running on the fastest speed in the background, and he died before I could use him. Don't be that guy who lets your main admiral die. Right, so we have the ship, we have an admiral, but what now? Well, I think it's time we declare war and take our baby out for a spin. What do you think? Okay, so let's go for our old friends, the Zhao. Right, we're making a few claims and then issue a conquest claim here. Remember, I am very overpowered right now, so this will be a cakewalk. But all I want to do is test our weapon. So, sorry dudes, but you are the guinea pigs. Fleet locked on and go. Right, so the time ship is like super slow, dudes. Like on the fastest speed, it's like it's on the slowest. But, I did just see here, oh yes, that little button, I can jump. So well happy about that. I love jumping in this game. I guess that it makes sense as, well, it is a time jumping ship after all. So here we are at the enemy planet. I've engaged the main gun, and now we just sit back and wait for it to charge up. Nearly there now, and here we go. Boom! Wow, yeah, love that. Let's take a look at the damage here. Okay, so it's telling us the attack was successful. Nice. The history has changed. Oh, yeah, so be careful, guys, because this could have an effect on us if we're not careful, just like in Voyager. But there we have it. We now occupy this planet as if we were the first to colonize it. So how cool is that? You know, I really enjoyed that, and I know you guys will too. So a bit of extra info here. You are meant to have a DLC called Apocalypse, which enables a doomsday machine here. But don't worry, because if you don't, the devs are awesome and they have a workaround. If you don't have the DLC, all you have to do is approach the planet as I did and just bombard it for a month. After that month, it will pop the event which you saw on mine, and it will tell you if anything went wrong, and it still gives you the planet exactly the same way. Basically, instead of seeing my weapon charge for a month, you'll just bomb it. So that's all I have here, guys. I hope you liked the video. That one took me ages to do, but I had loads of fun doing it, and I'm super happy to be back. And remember, if you need help with anything, just hit me or Jamie up and maybe try our other tutorials. If you want more and you like what you see, then why not subscribe to our channels? And if it's perfection of the game that you're after, then come and join our Discord, where we have loads of fun and really good chats. We call that our collective. Links will be in the description, guys, but that is it from me. Take care, and bye-bye for now.
Make it so.